1.21 gigawatts! Yes, the 80s, when I was in elementary school. There was a movie that came out that became one of my favorite movies called Back to the Future. Back to the Future 2 predicted a day in the future of what that was going to be like. They go into the future October 21st, 2015. And from the recording date of this video, that was just last week. Now, in that movie, they predicted time travel, they predicted flying cars, they predicted hoverboards, which are skateboards that have no wheels, that hover over the street and sidewalks. They predicted all kinds of really interesting things that I have looked forward to since the 80s. And some of those things came, some of those things did not come. But one thing that's really bugged me the most out of all those things that has not yet come was a working, usable hoverboard and time machine. So you're gonna help me build a hoverboard and a time machine. Now, if you're not sure what Back to the Future 2 is and you wanna check it out, click the link here before we get started with this experiment. Good morning, Emerald Shores Elementary School, fifth grade class of 2016. Back on October 21st, not too long ago, 2015, Back to the Future 2, a movie that you may not have ever heard of. The things that that movie presented to us was a future idea of what October 21st, 2015 would be like from a 1980s perspective. And well, some things came, some things were kind of a letdown. I don't see flying time machines or skateboards with wheels hovering over city streets and sidewalks, but I do know the science behind getting these possibilities to become reality. Today, I need your help. According to my investigation, I found that you all know and have studied Sir Isaac Newton's laws of motion, 1 and 2 to be exact. But in order to make time travel happen and for hoverboards to fly, we need the final piece. And that's Newton's third law of motion, which states, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. In order to bring reality to time travel and hoverboards, we need to overcome 2 obstacles. Identifying and describing where energy has caused motion or created changes by using the scientific method through 2 experiments with air and magnetism. Air to move the time machine and magnetism to overcome the force of gravity and allow our hoverboard to hover. Go ahead and get into groups of 4. Find your papers, put your names on the top, names. Now that you have your names on the top, let's review our essential question. Can you identify or describe examples where energy has caused motion or created changes? Let's do a quick review of Newton's first and second law. Newton's third law. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Let's get started. We're going to use the scientific method to investigate the use of air and magnetism to produce motion according to Newton's third law of motion. Go ahead and as a group, I want you to decide what you're going to experiment on. Are you going to build a time machine? Or are you going to build a hoverboard? Circle what you want. And you're going to fill in each box. The first one is observe, then question, then research, hypothesize, then your experiment, hypothesis tested, then your drawing conclusions, and then you're going to do your report. Now take a moment to observe this video of me conducting these 2 experiments and write down what you see. question box. Ask a question or identify a problem that will need to be overcome. So, what did you see that you don't quite understand? If you were to do that experiment and to make it work, what do you need to know? What was confusing and what do you need to figure out before you do the experiment? Write down your question. 1.21 gigawatts! Research. Now, have your team use the computer that's in front of you to research the answers to your question or problem. Use keywords like balloon car motion to research the time machine. And if you don't know how to research how to get this time machine going, go ahead and try these links here and here. Take time, check them out, and we'll bring it back in just a second. Time to hypothesize. Now, in your hypothesize box, how will you apply Newton's third law of motion in order to make the time machine move or to make the hoverboard hover? How will you do it?
All right, now it's time for your experiment.
Time for the experiment. Now, let's do the time machine materials. You need paper. You can either have this kind of paper or you can have some thick poster board. Either way, if you use this paper, you can just stack it on top of each other, use some tape to make it thicker. You need lifesavers, 4 of them. You need straws, 2 of them. You need tape. You need a balloon. And you need a rubber band for the hoverboard. Now, you need a lot of things, but you don't need them all. Now, for those of you doing the time machine, good luck. Here are some materials that you can use to try to make the hoverboard hover with the least amount of help possible. We have scissors, screwdriver, X-Acto knife, AA batteries, magnets that came from the magnet lab. We have compasses. Compasses are very important to know the polarity of a magnet. You need a skateboard. You need a circuit board. We'll need to research what to do with that. Square magnets, north and south polarized magnets, and if you zoom in on these really closely, these are very high powered magnets, neodymium. Very small, yet very powerful. Over here, we have a clothes hanger. And I will show you the experiment that I showed you before. You may now do your experiment. Follow the on paper directions for building your machine and use your research if you have any questions. Good luck. gigawatts. All right, guys, you know, if you've done your time machine, it should look something like this. Just kidding. This is a DeLorean from Back to the Future 2, if you didn't notice. And we have our wheels on, our axles, taped off the ends of our axles. And we have our straw running through the car with our balloon in front. Make sure that the straw exhaust is going out the back. And once you have it, I gotta do letter. Let it drive. Now we accept or reject our hypothesis. Did what we think work? Does it make sense? Write why it does or does not in the hypothesized box. Drawing conclusions. Findings from your experiment and make conclusions based on your hypothesis for either your time machine experiment or your hoverboard experiment now. All right, guys, wrap it up. Make sure all of your boxes are filled in. Take your time on the report section. And when you are done, go ahead and check out these links that I posted up here for you to see if others have been able to develop real-world hoverboards. Here, and here. Alright guys, go ahead and when you're done, line up. There is a race that we're going to do. Find the starting line and see who can go the farthest, the fastest. Ready? And when you're ready, watch it fly. Yay! 1.21 gigawatts!
And let it fly.
Everybody say cheese!